I'm a classic man. You can be mean when you look this clean. I'm a classic man. Calling on me like a young OG. I'm a classic man.
Your knees get... Hey, welcome back, my YouTube family. It's good to see you guys again. Listen, this is a YouTube channel for men ages 8 to 80. We discuss various topics such as fashion, finance, the criminal justice system, and how to become an alpha male through social intelligence. Listen, family, please make sure you subscribe, share, hit the notification button so you receive our new videos. We release a new video every Sunday at 5 p.m. Mountain Standard Time. Please make sure you check in, sit back, relax, enjoy the content. Now listen here, family. We're going to continue the series on how to wear a suit. I have five topics, five pieces of information that are very valuable for you today. First and foremost, number one, your tie should match the width and length of your lapel. In other words, if you have a thick tie, it should match the thickness of your lapel. A thin tie, thin lapel, because if it doesn't correspond, the symmetrics and the dynamics will be off. That's first and foremost, make sure they match and make sure they correspond. In general, busy shirt, solid tie, vice versa. Solid tie, busy shirt. You never want to kind of contrast the two. So in other words, if you have a lot of patterns in your shirt, stripes, polka dots, you should have a solid tie. Do not have a lot of things going on, it'll kind of contrast each other. All right, number three, never button the bottom button. As I'm displaying today, family, the bottom button should always be unbuttoned, only the top, all right? Another point, the fourth point, which is really critical, I see a lot of men missing this point, doesn't matter how old they are or how young they are. Remove the stitching from your suit, family. There's nothing more embarrassing than walking into a formal event, you have the stitching in your suit. Here's what I mean by that. On the back of your suit, the flaps, they're stitched together for shipping, for when you're transporting from the factory. Please, please make sure you remove the stitching from the back of your suit, remove the label from your sleeves, remove the label from your pocket square component. Make sure you remove all the stitching from your suit. And actually, when you go to the tailor or the cleaners, when they alter your suit, please ask them to remove all the stitching. Number five, the final point, wear long socks. In other words, family, when you're sitting down, your shins should not show, your socks should come up at least to the bottom of your knees. All right, now listen here, family. Here's a bonus point, bonus for you guys today. We're gonna talk about the proper way to wear your pocket square. Listen, family, anything goes right now, it's gonna be crazy. All right, let's get funky with it right now. My pocket square matches my shoes. Black and white polka dot, pocket square, black and white shoes. Here's a proper way to wear a pocket square. All right, family, listen, there are three ways to wear a pocket square. The first way, number one, have the pocket square in your hand, take your three fingers, grab the pocket square, now you have this form right here. Take the pocket square, place it in your suit. Now here's the most important thing, family. Once it's in there, fold it towards the suit. Once you fold it towards the suit, you have this nice pattern of a nice pocket square. Now this is the middle point as it relates to being formal. It's not too formal, but it's formal enough. Now listen, family, I'm gonna show you the most formal way to wear a pocket square. Same concept, very simple. You got your pocket square, you wanna grab it in the middle, grab it, fold it, but now it's upside down. Now listen here, family, here's why it's so formal. It's upside down, place in your suit, and now you can see the points. Whenever you have these points in your pocket square, it's an indication that it's a very formal event. Just tuck it down a little bit, like that, and now you have those points in your pocket square. Now, here's the last point, last way you can wear a pocket square. Super informal, you can wear this with jeans or just a regular blazer. Once again, pocket square, same steps, like that, put it in there, and you simply fold it in Now at this point, you just want to fluff it out. You see how the form that is? It's like a flower. You want to fluff it out. And those are three ways to wear pocket square. Alright family, thanks for checking in. It's good to see you guys. Remember, subscribe, share, hit the notification button so you can receive our new videos. See you soon.